Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight we want to have a look at this diamond tool holder from Eccentric Engineering in Melbourne, Australia. This is just a quarter inch square tool bit, ground on an angle, but this tool holder presents it in such a way that you can turn and face all on one setup. When this tool holder is perpendicular to the axis of the lathe, you can turn and face all in the same setup. The kit comes with a tool holder, tool bit. This is my quick change tool post holder. A grinding jig. No need to worry about back rake, side rake, any of that business. This jig makes it dead simple to get a nice face on there. I also purchased the round tool bit. Comes with a sticker. We're going to put it through its paces. We'll take the threads off of this. This is an anchor bolt. I don't know what kind of steel it is. I have to assume that it's a pretty good grade of steel. I think that's about an inch diameter. We have here some 1045 with a nasty saw cut on it. We'll clean that up. And we have here some 2.5 inch skid 80 pipe. We'll use our shop made plug for the end for tailstock support. This is called the knock it in with a hammer fit, and we'll see how it does on this. This is nasty stuff. Let's go over to the lathe. Okay, we'll start with this anchor bolt. We'll face off the end so we can center drill it. I have my bit dead on center height. Okay, we'll lock the carriage down. We'll auto feed. Watch in closer. that's left a pretty much gorgeous finish on the end of that nasty steel. Sorry about the bouncing around. I'll center drill that and reset and bring you back. Okay, we got the center drill done. We're set up now with tailstock support. I'm going to change my feed rate to a little bit coarser feed. Hold on. Okay, we'll touch off. And I'm gonna go with a 40 thou depth of cut. We'll see what happens. Took it like a trooper. That was 40 thou. Once you got into the uninterrupted area here, the lathe changed pitch. She was working a little bit, but no problem. Let's go, let's do a 50 thousandths depth of cut. Looks to be a very nice finish. I mentioned that I'm not using any cutting oil. I'm in my basement of my home, so no cutting oil. That was a 50 thou . Let's go 70, see what happens.
Thank you.
I'm intended to mention that all this we've seen so far is at 460 RPM. I'm going move that up to 755 RPM. I'm going to reduce our feed rate. And we'll take 10 thousandths off. Although it's a square tool bit, the way it's ground and the way it's held, this forms an 80 degree bend. I'm going to go into finishing mode. So I'm going to adjust my angle slightly so that we're having more of a contact area there. And suppose I wanted to take 1 thou depth of cut. If you did this with carbide, it would just tear up the stock and make a mess. Here we go, 1 thousandth depth of cut. I'll even go a little bit, we'll go up to 20 to 1,255 RPM. That's a very nice finish. It looks far worse than it feels. Go into chamfering mode here. Present the tool at 45 degrees. Or whatever degrees your chamfer needs to be. Only the tip of the tool is on center, so I assume if when you're chamfering, you want to be out near the tip. Anyway, she handled this mystery metal with no issues whatsoever. Did a great job. Mystery anchor bolt metal. Okay, we have our 2.5 inch skid 80 pipe checked up with our shop made tailstock support plug. We'll clean this all up right in one pass. 460 yards. I was just going to say, because it's all one continuous chip, cleanup is a breeze. I was going to make a joke, but that's no joke. That's not the tool's fault, that's my fault. I should have stopped and cleared the chips. She's left a very nice finish. Feels better than it looks again. That was a good heavy cut. I can't say how much because this pipe, when you start out, it's not even round, so it's tough to get a measurement on. Let's try full blown polishing mode. Not polishing, but fine mode. Just to see what happens. We'll touch off and take a tooth out depth of cut. Thank you. lovely job on the nasty pipe. Okay, we got our 1045 in there with that nasty cut face. We'll try the round tool bit in here to face that off just for giggles. These bits come pre-sharpened at the factory. Okay, first time with the round. Insert. I think I have it set up properly now. I'm finding that with the square one, I was having the tool holder perpendicular to the axis of the lathe. Here that doesn't seem to work, so I've got it set at about 30 degrees. We'll see what happens here. I may have to break out the instructions if all else fails. Seeing that it's characteristic of 1045 is that kind of a smeared appearance. I bought the extra round tool bits for, I do a lot of shaft work, and you never want to have a sharp transition between two diameters on a shaft. So this is for rounding, putting a fillet in on that shoulder. Let's see what happens if we just try and fillet this edge. Just for the heck of it. That's cool. You could use your top slide and do a chamfer on there, of course, too. All right, guys, that's it. We're going to wrap it up here. There you have it, guys. Diamond tool holder. Comes with a grinding jig, one bit. This is not just HSS, this is a certain percentage of cobalt. Comes with instructions, I should probably read them. But it did great. This was those rusty old threads off that anchor bolt. There's some nice usable stock there now. It did an awesome job on the OD of this pipe, and 1045, no problem. We saw heavy cuts up to 75 thou off the diameter. All my thou information, it refers to diameter. Could have gone deeper, probably. Didn't want to push my brand new tool. So hit the like button, leave a comment, subscribe to the channel. Stop by my store, lots of cool kits for the home shop machinists. Link in the description. Thanks for watching, guys. Take care. Enjoy your shop time.